Fundamental Christian Belief, Second Part.
今天的第二部分，基督教的信仰的基本知识，第二部分。
This is more for our own life, in a way.
这个呢，更多的是针对于我们的生活，生活形式。
We are first of all God's ambassadors, Bible says.
我们知道说，圣经上讲，我们是耶稣基督的大使。
Okay, we are sent here by God.
所以我们是被神差派到这个地上来。
Each one of you are sent.
每一个人都是被差遣的那一位。
By God, God called you.
神呼召了你。
God knew you.
神认识你。
God already planned you.
神计划在他计划当中。
As sons of God.
作为神的孩子。
Okay, do you believe that?
你相信你是神的儿子吗？
All right, before you become a king, you got to go through servanthood.
当你要成为一个王之前，你首先要经过一个仆人的阶段。
They need to learn all the things.
他需要先学习很多的知识，很多的事情。
So before the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, which is Jesus Christ.
所以当耶稣成为万王之王、万主之主之前
，We will be kings. Whoever served the Lord,
我们
whoever served the Lord will be their God's kings.
我们效法他的时候啊，神要把我们也要立作王，但是在做王之前，我们要先走过这个仆人的这个阶段。
Yeah.Under a king, the son becomes king, right? After that, under a father God, a father king,
在一个王，他的儿子最后也会继位成王。
So we are children of God.
所以我们既然作为神的孩子。
And God said He will let us also sit on His throne one day.
圣经上说，神要让我们有一天与他同坐在宝座上。
And God will also give us kingdoms to rule over, some 10, some 5, some.
圣经上也讲说，神要给我们国度来。掌管
two,、right?
有的时候是十个，有的是五个，有的是两个。
You need to multiply it in your life, right?
那么你在你的生活当中 multiply what?
Whatever God has given you.
所以你要在你的生活当中，让你所神赐给你的，你要让它加倍出来，加倍的生长
出来。God has given us this faith.
神给了我们这样的一个信心。
We better give other people faith too.
那么你也要给别人同样的信心。
God has given us this salvation.
神给了我们救恩。
You better multiply and give other people salvation.
那你也要把这个救恩加倍的在别人身上。
That's what we're here doing.
这个是我们要去做的，这也是我们想要去做的。
Every day, according to His will.
每天照着他的心意。
Okay, so that's the fundamental Christian belief, like who you are.
所以基督教信仰的一个基本核心的第二个点就是你是谁。
And while you're doing those things,
当你在做这些事情的时候
，God blesses you.
神会祝福你。
God multiplies you.
神也会让你所有的丰盛。
Okay, God multiplies your family.
他让你的家庭丰盛。
Your friends.
你的
Your,
朋友也更多
anything, everything.
你所有的这些都会越来越多
In the midst of it, you become blessed.
在这个过程当中，你就变得自己变得很蒙福
And with the blessings, you are able to give.
而神给你这样的一个祝福，让你可以更多的去祝福其他人，分享给其他人
okay, Which is the point of your blessings, anyway. And as you see, okay, when we first came to China, okay.
比如说，你们可以看到我们刚来中国的时候。
We rented a room, one room.
我们租了一个一居室
For 3,000 yen.
3,000块钱的一个一居室
One month, okay?
一个月
This house.
这个房子 也是3,000块
3,300 yen, okay?
也是3,000多
Do you understand? God's blessing? You serve God, you bless God, you do His work, God will bless you. It's a promise.
当你在开始服侍神、祝福、为神工作的时候，神也会在你的生活当中不断来祝福你
You'll always go up, you'll never go down.
当你不断的为神做工，你的生活也会往上走，而不是往下走。
But depending what you do, depending what you do on earth,
取决于你在这个世界上面做的怎么样。
You will either be blessed or be cursed.
你会就会决定了你是有一个祝福的人生呢，还是一个被咒诅的人生。
So these are the laws.
所以这个地方就讲到我们基督徒生活当中的一些准则。
How to
核心。
Live a blessed life.
如何在这个地上活出一个蒙福的生活
？We're not only talking about money as a blessing. Money is.
我说的这个祝福不仅仅只是一个金钱，
okay.
金钱很多时候还可能是一个咒诅。
Just have enough, but everything satisfied is blessing.
而是你一有一有时，什么都很知足，那种才是祝福。
Okay, so we need to be followers like Jesus Christ, like the disciples, exactly.
我们要像耶稣的门徒一样的去跟随耶稣。
Okay, the Great Commission, right? We know.
我们都知道大使命。
Yeah, but in order to do the Great Commission,
但是如果你想要去做这个大使命的话
you don't go out into the battlefield as a baby. Do you know what I'm saying?
你不能说你还是个婴孩的时候，你就冲上了战场，就开始去打仗。
Killed in no time.
你会被瞬间秒杀。
Do you understand? you need to be at a certain level, you know, be able to evangelize well.
你要在你的生命要成长到一定的阶段，你去传福音的时候才会更加有的果效，并且有更加的有力量。
In order to do that, you need to be disciplined.
所以你要想达到这样的一个阶段，
like
就需要像门徒那样有一个非常自律的生活。
Jesus had disciples.
耶稣有这样的一群门徒。
He was in a way training them.
他这一群门徒对他来说，他就在训练他们。
Teaching them.
他在教导他们。
What he do, you better do.
耶稣做什么就做给他们看，叫他们跟着学。
And he expect them to do.
然后他也希望他的门徒跟着一起做。
Watch and learn how he live.
一边看一边模仿，照着去做。
Now how can we do that now?
那我们现在怎么办呢？
We have the word of God.
我们有神的话语。
Okay.And we have the body of Jesus Christ.
我们也有基督的身体。
And then we have the Lord Jesus, the Holy Spirit.
我们还有主耶稣所赐下的这个圣灵作为我们的老师，在我们的中间。
Okay. So we can learn and do the same.
所以我们现在也可以做同样的事情。
Understand? It's not a mystery. And in order to be the disciple, they had to give up everything, willing to let go everything in the beginning, willing to let go at least everything.
像耶稣的门徒一开始，他们为了神的国度，他们就必须要放弃他们所有的一切。
Okay.Be willing to make God may not ask you to let go everything, you know, in the beginning.
一开始我说的这个地方是愿意的心，不是说真的要放弃所有的东西，因为可能是一开始没有想让你放弃所有的东西。
Okay.
但是要有这个愿意的心。
But you have that heart ready.
就你的心是准备好的。
God called you like Abraham, go here, then you gotta go there.
如果神有一天跟你说，像亚伯拉罕对他说，你去哪里，你就可以马上就去。
Give me your son, then you gotta be giving.
给我你的儿子，你就给得出来。
Okay.Gotta be ready.
就你的心要预备好。
Whatever the Lord wants.
要愿意。等到主一发命令的时候，你就可以马上做得出来。
Let's read Luke 14.
路加福音第14章26节到27节说：人到我这里来，若不爱我胜过爱自己的父母、妻子、儿女、弟兄、姐妹和自己的性命，就不能做我的门徒。凡不背着自己的十字架跟从我的，也不能做我的门徒。
Yeah.Right, you cannot love anything else, everything more than God at all. Okay?
他说你不能超过爱神，超过爱其他东西，超过爱神。
And you need to bear your cross.
而且还需要你背你的十字架。
Cleanse yourself from your former lifestyle.
也说你要将你从你过去的这种生活模式当中要被净化出来，要被脱离出来。
Anything that is against God or not pure or clean.
过去的一切的这种不合神心意的这一些。不符合神教导的这样的一种生活方式都要脱离出来。
Drinker needs to stop drinking.
比如说酗酒的人要停止喝酒。
Party people need to stop partying.
喜欢宴乐的人需要停止宴乐。
Love the world people need to stop loving the world.
爱世界的人要停止爱世界。
Okay, it takes sacrifice.
他需要很多的这个舍弃和牺牲。
And with Jesus, you can do all things.
但是靠着耶稣基督，我们就可以凡事都能做。
He'll give you the power to.
他会给你这样的一个能力去做。
You don't just do it out of your own will. You're almost impossible.
你不是说我靠自己的力量去做，你靠自己是做不了。
Okay, so you just depend on God. Prayer, make me.
你是在祷告当中，你靠神。
Please help me.
神，你帮助我，你让我去做，你让我能够做成。
God will help you.
那么神就会帮助你。
Okay, so it'll be God's work.
所以这边呢是神在你生命当中的工作。
Let the Lord do the surgery.
而你只是让他来在你生命当中做这样的一个外科手术。
Okay, so basic things how to overcome these sins or these addictions of this world. How do you do that?
那么我们如何可以战胜我们生命当中的这个罪和上瘾呢？
Because when you come.Most people will be struggling with sins, secret sins.
刚来到神面前的时候，我们每一个人都带着自己一些罪恶呀、上瘾的东西或者一些隐藏的这些恶在里面。基督既在肉身受苦，你们也当将这样的心智当作兵器，因为在肉身受过苦的，就已经与罪断绝了。你们存这样的心，从今以后就可以不从人的情欲。只从神的旨意在世度余下的光阴，因为往日随从外邦人的心意行邪淫恶欲醉酒荒宴群饮并可恶拜偶像的事，时候已经够了。
Okay, it's enough that you live in your drunkenness and your whatever lifestyle.
他说你过去行那些外邦人那些生活方式应该已经够了。
And if you go through the sufferings of Christ,
他说你要经历像基督在肉身受苦的这样的一个有这样的一个心智。
Like fasting,
比如说禁食
praying,
祷告
and giving up all those things,
以及舍弃放弃
When you go through those pains,
当你经历了这些痛苦的时候，在肉身的受苦
you will eventually able to overcome.
你在罪上面就可以断绝它，断绝
Okay? But if you have all those things together, you cannot overcome.
但是如果你有一切享受肉体的这些东西都在你的身边，你就没有办法断绝罪。
You cannot.
你没有办法断绝罪。
You get tangled and tangled together.
因为你会被这些罪反复的缠绕，以至于你没有办法脱身。
So, like fasting is very basic things to start with.
所以禁食是作为一个基督徒来说是个很基础的一个操练方式。
Without fasting, you cannot become spiritually strong. Cannot.
没有禁食的话，你在灵里面很难刚强起来。
So that's why whenever I told you guys before, when you believe, you gotta fast.
所以你们很多人刚信主的时候
，kills the flesh.
刚信主我就跟你们开始禁食，要禁食，因为禁食可以对付很多肉体上面的东西。
And you need to read a lot of Word of God.
你要读很多很多的圣经。
Always be praying.
然后常常的祷告。
These are all biblical.
这都是很基础的，是符合圣经的一些教导。
Look, Matthew 26:40 says.
马太福音第26:40节说。耶稣来到门徒那里，见他们睡着了，就对彼得说：“怎么样？你们不能同我警醒片时吗？总要警醒祷告，免得入了迷惑。你们心灵固然愿意，肉体却软弱了。”
God knows you're willing to stop the sin, but you cannot overcome the sin if you don't pray.
所以你看，耶稣他是知道我们里面想要去对付罪的这样的一个心灵，我们心灵是愿意的。但是肉体却是做不到的。
And he was angry.
所以他是很不满意的。
You can't pray 1 hour.
他说你们不能同我警醒片时，这个片时是一个小时。
And he himself went back and forth 3 times.
而耶稣这样来来回回去了三趟。
Pray same way.
所以同样的方式又回去祷告。
So he prayed 3 hours.
所以他大概是祷告了三个小时。
Okay, about 3 hours. Do you understand? And he was able to carry the cross.
然后他才有这个力量说可以去背这个十字架。
We're the same.
而我们也是这个样子。
We need to model our life based on the Lord Jesus.
我们要效法我们的生活是基于耶稣基督的生活方式。
If you don't pray 1 hour,
如果我自己祷告不到一个小时
，Jesus will tell you the same thing.
耶稣也会跟你讲说，你不能同我警醒片刻。
What? Can I pray 1 hour?
你不能祷告一个小时吗
？Understand? So when like sometimes, okay, when I was like kind of tired and we don't want to pray, you know, I had a Bible verse in my bathroom in the other house.
在我之前住的那个家里面，我在厕所里面贴了一张那个经文的那个经文，然后有的时候，有点软弱，有的时候不想祷告，或者是很累的时候。
It was like kind of like behind the door that I don't all this time see it. You know?
然后呢，我不就把那个经文贴在那个厕所的背后的门后面。我一般很少会看那个经文。
And then you know I don't want to pray, and then I looked at it, it was like right there. What? You cannot pray one.
然后有一天我就很不想祷告，然后一抬头就看那句话说：“你就不能跟我警醒片时吗？”
Okay.
然后就马上赶紧祷告。
So very important.
所以很重要。
Pray.
祷告是很重要的。
Also.When you have the temptation, I told you how.
然后当试探来临的时候，我们教过你是不是要说什么？经上记着说。
Right, you have to fight that idea.
你要用圣灵借着圣经的话去抵挡这样的一个想法。
A lustful thinking come in, let's say.
比如说一个很淫乱的想法进来。
Bible says you shall not commit adultery.
圣经上说我们不能行奸淫。
Okay, 经上记着说。
经上记着说。
你要爱神。With all your heart, all your soul.
你要全心全意的去爱神
，right? And you can 宣告，
你就可以宣告出来。
You can also say, I don't love those things.
我不喜欢这些东西。
That's not me.
我这个不喜，这个不是我。
You get up.
所以这个里面这个想法离开我。
Okay, so you gotta do that. Also, you need to close all the open doors.
然后你要关上那些你敞开的门。
Okay. Cut off the soul ties.
你要剪断一些。不敬虔的连接。
Unfortunately, we had a sister that kind of went away. Okay, we need to cut the soul ties from her. Why? Because their demons keep on coming. If you keep on thinking about her, their demons come. And, you know what I'm saying?
比如说，最近我们有姐妹啊，这样的这个离开教会，我们是需要去剪断和她的这些不敬虔的这些魂结。因为如果我们反反复复的去思想这些事情的时候，他们的这些就很多这些邪灵就会借机来继续的来攻击我们，
oh, too. Oh,
来继续的想看你能不能来抓住你的这个把柄来迷惑你。
So you proclaim.
所以我们要宣告出来。
I don't have anything to do anymore.
比如说我跟什么什么事情，或者我跟某某人、
okay.
啊，没有任何的这个不敬虔的连接，全部都要斩断。
Okay.My sisters and my brothers are those who do the will of God.
就像耶稣说，他说我的母亲和我的兄弟姐妹是那些行天父旨意的人。
Okay, it's not just whatever people, understand? So, it says here, abstain from fleshly lust which war against the soul.
彼得前书说，亲爱的弟兄，你们是客旅，是寄居的，我劝你们要禁戒肉体的私欲，这私欲是与灵魂征战。
Another Bible verse says, you know, even.Don't even partake something that looks evil, something that even every appearance of evil, abstain from every appearance of evil.
这个地方说要禁戒肉体的私欲，在圣经另外一个地方讲到说我们要远离甚至那些外表上看上去有诱惑或者是有恶的这种样子的这些东西，我们都要远离，有他这个外表的也要远离。
Anything that look like devil.
看上去就感觉像跟魔鬼相关的东西都要远离。
Okay. Or magic or.
比如说魔法啦，魔术魔法啦，或者是巫术啦这种。
A lot of Japanese animation have those things.
比如说像很多的日本动画片里面，有很多的魔法的东西。
Okay, those are really model after demons.
这些都是，就是帮我下去看一下宝宝是不是在哭。
Okay.
宝宝好像他是一个人在房间里面。
Those things are actually that's how they look. You don't want to see a demon. That's how they look. You know, in the movies, whatever.
所以有的时候电影里面，这种电视里面，它有很多这种模仿魔鬼的一些东西。你要想知道魔鬼怎么样运行，哎，你在那些里面就可以看到。他是在一楼，他在一楼。
Okay, so you close all those doors.
所以这一些敞开的门呢，要把它关闭。
Very important, okay? Now, cast out every thought demons captive in Jesus' name.
要 cast out every thought demons captive, 什么意思？
Like, let's read here, let's read here.
Okay, 我们先看这个经文吧。
哥林多前书，哥林多后书十章四节。
妈妈在哪？
哦，我妈在哄她吗？
在哄她呀，但是
看不
到。My mom's
in
bed.
My mom, 我来读这个经文。
Then you do that, okay?
我们一起来看一下哥林多后书第十章第四到六节。我们征战的兵器本不是属血气，乃是在神面前有能力，可以攻破坚固的营垒，将各样的计谋。各样拦阻人认识神的那些至高之事一概攻破了，又将人所有的心意夺回，使他都顺服基督，并且我已经预备好了，等你们十分顺服的时候，要责罚那一切不顺服的人。所以他这个地方讲到就是说要攻破所有坚固的营垒，仇敌在我们生命当中的这些营垒也好，然后还要将这些计谋全部都要攻破，还要将
We bind them. That's how we make them captive. Okay.
这个地方
bind them.
夺回的这个意思呢，就是说是使他被俘虏。
Jesus said, "You the first bind the strong man."
圣经上说，耶稣说，你们要进到那个壮士家的时候，先要怎么样？把那个壮士先捆绑起来。
Okay. Right.
对不对？
So we bind it in Jesus' name.And we imagine that it's being bound by the Holy Spirit power.
所以我们先要把他们先
捆绑他们，
捆绑他们，对。
And you cast them out in Jesus' name. Cast them out, take them out.
然后呢，对于邪灵来说，我们是要捆绑了，把他赶出去。然后这地方是 bring every thought, 就是 human thought into obedience.
It's not just to bring every thought. It could be human thought or demonic thought, whatever thought is put into your mind that exalts itself against the Bible.
就是说所有的这一切拦阻人认识神的这些自高自大的事，可以是可能是这些是从仇敌来的这些想法，也有可能人自己的这个想法。
Like for example, we are not fighting our own flesh. Okay, we're not fighting hormones.
我们不是说要去征战的是我们的血气，也就是说不是你身体的一些，比如说荷尔蒙啊，或者是一些激素啊，这些东西。
We're not. Okay, do you understand? We're not fighting that. There's a spirit behind it.
是我们背后有这样的一个。灵在这样的攻击我们。
We're not fighting our own greed.
我们其实也不是说要征战的是我们里面的这样的一个。
It's a demon.
一个贪婪啊，或者是欲望啊。
It's keep on telling you to eat that, eat that, take that, get that.
是因为旁边一直有这样的一个诱惑，一直在诱惑我们，把我们的罪性里面光勾出来，让我们去做这样的事情。
We're not fighting chemicals in the cigarettes, okay?
我们要征战的不是说我这个抽烟里面这个烟里面的这个尼古丁。
We're not fighting the alcohol like the.Alcohol, okay? 也不是说要去
抵挡的是这个酒精本身。
Nobody should be addicted to anything.
我们不是说要，
Understand?
我们每一个人都不应该有任何的上瘾的东西。
Oh, poison. Oh, why you might keep on drinking poison?
因为你知道这个酒精对你身体不好，但是你还要继续喝，说明你没有拒绝的能力。
People don't get addicted to good things like water. Nobody gets addicted to water.
但是好的东西别人就不会上瘾啊。喝水我见人没有见人上瘾嘛。
Do you know what I'm saying? Oh, I cannot keep on drinking.
没有人说我喝水控制不住，我要一直喝，一直喝，一直喝。
All the good stuff you don't get addicted.
好的东西不见得会上瘾。
Bad stuff you get addicted.
但是坏的东西却容易上瘾。
You understand? So it's a spirit. It's a thought.
这其实是背后的一个想法，这样的一个灵的一个捆绑。
So whatever you want in the world is a demonic spirit.
所以在这个世上，很多这些背后的这些欲望。 后面都是邪灵。
You captive those things, get out in Jesus' name, out, out, out. When they're gone, you don't feel like doing that.
你把他家这些想法全部都攻破，全部把他们都捆绑，把他们扔出去，把他们赶出去。
Okay.
你的心意念里面就会有很多的这个，就可以顺服耶稣基督。
We have as sons of God the authority to captive and cast them out from our life.
我们作为神的儿女是有权柄，在地上捆绑，在天上就捆绑，
okay.
就可以捆绑这一些邪灵的这些计谋。
So use the word of God, proclaim the word of God.
宣告神的话，用神的话。
And captive these thinking in Jesus' name and cast them out from you.
然后呢，把这些想法通通的这些赶出去，跟我们圣灵赶出去。
Treat every idea as demonic, because they are demonic.
Every idea.
Every bad idea.、
Oh, every bad idea.
Demonic.
我们每一个在你脑海当中恶的想法，你都把它当成邪灵来看待的时候，你就比较容易攻破了。
Okay, don't receive it and ponder. Oh yeah.
你不要去想，
yeah.
不要去默想它，不要去反复的咀嚼它，思考它。
Oh, love the word. Get out in Jesus' name.
一个想法进来，哦，爱邪的心，赶紧扔出去，赶紧拒绝。
Oh, this lustful thinking. Get out in Jesus' name.
一个淫乱的想法进来，赶紧把它赶出去，
not,
不要让它留在你脑海。
That's not what you want. You know what I'm saying?
因为你知道那不是你自己想要的。
Okay,
你不希望它停留在你的思想里面，你就把它给它赶出去。
So, you know, you gotta think of like it's like the spiritual warfare is like how the spider catches things.
我们可以从这个蜘蛛它捕捉食物的这样的一个方式来看待属灵征战。
God designed it, right? You know how a fly gets caught here?
你们知道这个一个飞虫是怎么样在这个蜘蛛上面、蜘蛛网上面被抓住，然后被吃掉吗
？Like a bug, like lands on it, right?
一个虫子停在那个网上面。
Okay, maybe like one leg.
它可能就停了一个脚在上面。
If they move quickly, they can get out.
如果这一个脚它挣脱一下，它就可以跑掉了。它站不住。
But if they get and then another leg get in the
然后一个脚上去以后，另一个脚也搭上去了。
Then you're in trouble. Then you get tangled.
然后你就越被捆，越捆越深，越捆越深，就被捆住了。
That's how it's with the demonic thoughts.
很多的时候，仇敌的思想也是这样。
There are a bunch of thoughts.
你看，它有很多很多的，就像很多人的想法。在你脑海当中
you let that touch you. You go in there, you touch one of these thoughts.
然后你进去呢，然后你一个脚踩在了一个想法上面。
Oh, this kind of lustful thinking come, right? For example.
比如说一个什么淫乱的想法进来了。
Okay. You heard say, Jesus, get up and fight with the world right away.
然后你马上奉耶稣基督的名把它赶出去。
Understand? But if you keep on dwelling and thinking about it, you connect thoughts another, and you're touching everything, now you're tangled.
越想越深呢，然后你就想的越来越多，你的想法就会被这个情欲的这个想法呢，就会被纠缠进去。
Okay, love of money, same thing. Talking about money, thinking about money, and next thing you're thinking, and then you're already caught by the greed. You're already tangled in that stuff, and you're like fuzza thinking.
当你想着要去赚钱，然后更想要赚钱，然后越想怎么想怎么赚，最后那个就被这种爱钱的心就被缠住。
Now the devil got you, you know.
然后呢，这个时候仇敌就得到你的那个思想，占领了你的思想。
Now you're in bondage.You know, captive. Cannot keep on thinking about this. Cannot get out of it.
然后就变成了一个捆绑的状态，就是你没有办法控制自己不去想。
Okay, this is exactly how.
就变成像这个蜘蛛一样，就在蜘蛛网上面被捆住一样。
So when you land it, oh, it's sticky. Get out of there.
所以当你一个脚踩上去的时候，你发现不对劲，赶紧跑。
Okay, understand? Right away, every thought captive. Very quickly, you gotta be.On top of it.
所以就是要警醒，知道自己的每一个。
Watch out.
注意到自己的每一个这样的一个想法。
Devil trying to get you and then eat you up like the thing, eat up the bug.
他想要把你吞吃，就像一个吃掉这个虫子一样。
Okay, don't get caught into that. Bible says Peter 5:8. Man, you don't do this forever.
彼得前书第五章第八节说：“务要谨守警醒，因为你们的仇敌魔鬼如同吼叫的狮子，遍地游行。”寻找可吞吃的人，你们要用坚固的信心抵挡他，因为知道你们在世上的众弟兄也是经历这样的苦难。
Everyone is going through temptation, not only you.
所以每一个人都要经历很多的试探，很多的这些魔鬼的这些搅扰攻击，这是每个人都要经历的。
You touch one of that idea, you need to hurry up and get out before it tangle up in there. Understand in the spider web.
所以你在这个蜘蛛网上面，你一个想法它。一个邪恶的想法沾到你的时候，你要赶紧把它挣脱出去，而不是继续的萦绕在你的思想当中，以至于被完全的捆绑住。
Okay, the devil's trying to eat you.
因为仇敌要怎么吞吃你
？He says, "Be vigilant." He's watchful.
要谨守，要警醒。
Oh, No, no, I shouldn't think that stuff because that's demonic thought.
当你一个想法进来，你马上就警醒，说这个想法不对。
The
spring. 这个想法是贪婪。
Oh, the 淫乱。Oh, no.
是淫乱或怎么样？我要去把它
get out,
拒绝它。你不要允许这个想法在你的思想当中。
You know, be watchful.
要警醒。
Oh, that thing I shouldn't watch.
这个东西我不应该看。
Why all this devil stuff?
因为这是魔鬼的东西。
That's a no. I need to hurry up before you get tangled.
所以当你还没有被陷进去之前，你赶紧逃出来。
It's very sticky. Do you understand?
这个罪是非常的
very sticky,
像这个蜘蛛网一样。
It's very hard to even take up that.
很黏糊，你脚踩上去，你想挣脱一只脚出来也很难。
You need to use the sword of the spirit and cut it off.
这个就需要用那圣的宝剑去把它砍断。
The word of God, cut it off. Okay.
砍断之间的这个连接。
And don't get two hands, three hands. Okay.
不要什么两个手两个脚全部都会黏住了，你就很难再逃脱了。
It's very hard to come out. You need to proclaim you don't love those things. I have nothing to do with that. Devil, get out. 宣告。
在这个过程当中，你可以去宣告你与他没有任何的这个连接。所以要约束你们的心，谨慎自守，专心盼望耶稣基督显现的时候所带来给你们的恩。你们既做顺命的儿女，就不要效法从前蒙昧无知的时候那放纵私欲的样子。那召你们的既是圣洁，你们在一切所行的事上也要圣洁，因为经上记着说，你们要圣洁，因为我是圣洁。你们既称那不偏待人按个人行为审判人的主为父，就当存敬畏的心度你们在世寄居的日子。
So whenever worldly thinking come in, what do you say? It is written, be holy as for I am holy, as I am holy.
所以你想当这些罪恶的想法进来，或者是爱世界的新想法进来，你就可以用这句话说，经上记着说，你们要圣洁，因为我是圣洁的。
这想法从耶稣里离开。
所以这样的这种罪恶的想法要离开我，因为我要圣洁。
It's written, be holy as I am holy.
经上记着说，我要圣洁。因为神是圣洁的。
Amen. That's enough to fight off almost all the lust and greed.
基本上这一句话你都可以抵挡大部分的这些、
okay.
罪恶的想法。
Amen. So just use that. Be holy as I am holy. Now there is spiritual authority. So, you know.
然后第二点要讲的是关于不是精神是属灵的权柄。
属灵的权柄 ，right? Let's read Romans 13.
在上有权柄的，人人当顺服他，因为没有权柄不是出于神的。凡掌权的都是神所命的，所以抗拒掌权的就是抗拒神的命，抗拒的必自取刑罚。
Unless God said do that, don't talk bad about the number one government, okay?
所以首先我们不要讲政府的坏话。
Okay, understand? Very important.
这很重要。
Don't do that, okay? Just because God said the whole government.
因为所有的权柄，在上的权柄都是神所设立的。
Yeah, they may not do everything correct, okay?
他们可能做的事情不见得是很正确。
But if God put them there, we need to at least respect their law.
但是神把这样的一个掌权的放在我们的上面，我们就应该要尊重。
If you do not follow the spiritual authority,
如果你不追跟随这个属灵上的这个权柄
，Bible says you're going to be judged.
圣经上说，抗拒的必自取刑罚。
I don't want nobody to be judged, right?
我不希望我们中间有自取刑罚。所以我们要尊重他们。
We have to understand we are not God.
因为我们不是神。
Okay, we are under God.
我们是在神的底下。
Have the godly fear.
所以我们有一个就是像神就对神那样一个敬畏的一个心，对权柄敬畏的心。
So in a household,
在家里面也是这样子。
The top is God.
一个在家庭当中，神是家的头。
And then it's a man.
然后是男人。
And then it's the wife.
然后是妻子。
And then children.
然后是孩子。
Okay, the wife shouldn't have overpowering power over the husband's decision.
妻子不能有这个，就是在做决定的上面不能有，就是越过丈夫的这样的一个做决定的一个行为。
Unless the man is going against God.
除非丈夫所做的决定是违背神旨意。
Okay, so in God's word it says, gather all the more as you see the day approaching, right?
比如说圣经上说，你们不要停止聚会。尤其是当你们看到主来的日子近了
，right? Then we need to obey God's law.
那么我们要更多的去顺服神。
Just because a husband says don't go to church, don't read Bible, you cannot do that.
比如说，如果你的丈夫说不要去聚会
，don't read Bible. No, it is written.
他说不要读圣经。
Man shall live by not by bread alone.
那么这个就是不合神心，因为神经上说人不能单靠食物活着，还要靠神口中所说的话。
Understand? God's laws above.
所以神的律是超出人的律。
Above all the society and everything.
也超出这个社会的这个律。
Understand?
嗯。
So the society, obviously God.
社会当中。
Kings, rulers, and then
最高权柄是神，然后是君王，然后是统治者，然后是公民。
And you give them their respect.
所以我们要给他们要有这样的一个。尊重
you can 建议 you can do something not right
提建议
you
你可以提建议
no problem okay they may not know understand but you shouldn't dishonor them
但是我们不能说不尊重他
okay next work
然后在工作里面
boss
就是老板
you respect
你的上司还有对就是有这样的一个次序
okay and then age older man
在年纪当中
higher than you
年老的年老的男人，年老的妇女要
，older woman is your mothers and your fathers.
是在这个年轻的这个妇人的或者年轻人的这个权柄之上。
Right, honor your father and mother is the fifth commandment. Same thing.
比如说，像在家里面尊重父母也是一样，敬重孝顺父母也是这样的，因为他是有这样的一个年龄的这样的一个、
okay.
次序。
In the church,
教会里面
，you need to respect the authorities.
也有这样的一个次序。
So if there's apostles make the final decision.
那使徒做最终的决定。
Okay, if there's pastors, the pastors.
然后下面是牧师。
Elders and elders.
然后长老。
The leaders.
然后各个领袖。
Okay.
然后还会众。
You need to follow. You can discuss.
你可以跟他们讨论。
But they need to make the final decision.
但是他们要做最后的决定。
Okay, respect the decision.
你要尊重他们所做的决定。
Understand?
对。
Yeah, very important. Because if you go against that, then I'm cursing myself. Why would I do that?
所以当我们如果抗拒权柄，所以这个在这个社会、家庭、教会里面这些权柄。都是非常的重要，因为如果我们不去做的话，他很容易给我们自招刑罚。
And God gives grace to the humble.
神赐恩给谦卑的人。
Humble is those who submit.
而谦卑的一个很大的一个特征就是会顺服权柄。
God's authority in the church, in the world, everywhere.
这个权柄在你的教会里面，在你的家庭当中，在你社会的阶层里面，他都会愿意去顺服。
When you so go down before God, you kneel before the Lord. When you go before the Lord, you kneel.
所以我们在神的面前，我们屈膝敬拜，屈膝跪拜。
And you raise your hands. These are all just talking about basic doctrine. Okay.
这些都是很基础的一些我们的一些生活上面的一些
Raise your hands.
比如说我们会举手敬拜，我们在祷告当中会举起手，会赞美会举起手。
会赞美他 ，OK？
都是一种的表示尊重的一个方式。
How to pray?
如何祷告
？OK。Time and quality,
时间
very important.
长度和质量都非常的重要
Why? One minute, 5 minute prayer is really like too cheap. You know?
你一分钟、五分钟的祷告实在是太廉价了
It's time like unless you're like before eating.
除非你是吃饭之前、做饭前祷告
But 平时 you should always be praying.
但是你平时应该是有一个常常祷告的一个生活习惯。
Every day,
每一天都有一个这个很认真祷告的一个习惯。
Bible says pray without ceasing.
圣经上说，不住的祷告，不住的祷告就是没有停止的祷告，
okay.
一直停，一直在祷告。
It's 2.5 hours just like a law.
所以你看，我给你们两个半小时，就像个律法一样的，好像给你们框了个框在那个地方。
You want to be in the grace.
但是你想要进到恩典当中
，which means everything.
那你就是全部都要给他不住的祷告。
Do you understand? So I'm giving you like minimum. This is minimum.
所以这个。这是属于律法，给你们的是一个最低标准。
Okay, 最低。
最低标准。
Okay, 2.5. Okay, so you want to go max. Okay, so 3.0 hours plus. Why? 2.5 hours is just really good for yourself.
当你祷告，我照着我自己的一个个人经验来看，两个半小时的祷告，只能
just good for me.
维持你自己生活当中刚强。
Good enough for me to do all the thing and be happy.
让你自己里面有
平安。
有行的，然后有所有的这些事情都很丰盛、很充足，
That's just good enough
然后行在神的旨意里，这是为你自己的生活能够顺顺利利的过下去。
Yeah.
两个半小时。
When you're trying to save other people，
但如果你想要开始去做神的工作，你开始要为别人代祷，你开始想要去传福音
，You need more，
你需要更多的祷告。
It really, if you're praying for a husband and wife，
如果你开始要为你的丈夫、为你的妻子
，It's like saving somebody，
开始代祷的时候
，It's like saving somebody。
当你想要去，比如说拯救别人、救别人的时候
，You need to put like double time for that person。
你可能需要加倍的时间去为那个人再花很多的钱去代祷。
Do you know what I'm saying? It's not easy。
所以没有那么容易。
But you can't do it. I did it. You know, I prayed 10 hours a day those times. You know, and it came.
但是是可以做到的。你如果一个人的话，祷告十个小时也是可以的。
When you're by yourself, it's easy.
如果你一个人生活的话
，Single is easy.
你单身的话，其实很容易祷告的。
Nobody's there.
也没人吵你。
Nobody need to talk to you.
没有人要跟你讲话。
So pray all day long.
你就可以从早到晚就在祷告。
Okay, in your car, you're praying.
你开车的时候，
nobody talking to you.
一直在祷告，因为没有人跟你讲话。
Okay, it's very easy. Why can't you do it?
所以我们可以去试。
Put your heart and mind in it.
你要把你的心智放在里面，说我要去这样做，我就可以做到。
When you're taking time to pray, focus.
当我们祷告的时候，要专注。
Every second is important.
每一秒都很重要。
Put your heart in it.
把你的心放进去。
Then really fire. That's where fire comes.
当你专注进去的时候，你就会感觉到这个火苗开始燃烧起来。
Okay. When the light is in the center, like gather into center, fire come out, right?
当太阳光聚集到一个点的时候，就会怎么样？烧起来。
Focus, if fire come out.When your mind is focused,
当你的思想专注进去的时候，就会有火出来。
If you do that properly in 10-20 minutes, you still have some fire.
如果当你在很专注祷告的时候，可能十分钟、二十分钟，你就可以感觉到很火热在里面，就开始烧起来。
When they make fire, they like roll the thing.
钻木取火的时候就是搓搓搓搓搓搓。
In one place, in one point.
在一个点上面拼命的搓。
And it creates fire.
然后就烧起火来了。
Same thing.
一样的。
You don't think you have fire?In your life,
你觉得你生命当中
fire,
缺少一些火热？
迫切的祷告 ，fire，
迫切的祷告。
Is it biblical? It's very biblical.
这个是这是圣经当中教导。
Okay. In Hebrews, Jesus prayed that way.
在希伯来书讲到说，耶稣就是这样祷告。
Pray so hard, even blood come out through his sweat.
在大声哀哭什么什么什么。
大声哀哭 ，then fearing God.
然后因为他这个敬畏神的心，然后他的那个祷告得了蒙了应许。
And fervent prayers of a righteous man availeth much.
然后圣经上说，义人的这个火热的祷告是大有功效。
Elijah prayed like until his head went into his knees.
以利亚祷告的时候，把头都埋到整个膝盖里面去了。
Seven times.
祷告了七次。
Okay, so we're talking about that kind of prayer.
所以我们在讲就是这样类型的祷告。
We don't look at other Christians how they pray five minutes.
一定要看其他的基督徒，其他基督徒祷告五分钟、十分钟。
Okay.You go to your church, everybody's weak.
但如果你去他们的教会
weak, you know, because they don't have
prayer life. 他会告诉你他们很软弱，很软弱。
Do you understand? Okay, so please don't look at that as your role model. Look at Jesus as your role model.
你要把耶稣作为你的一个榜样。
Amen. That's he's our role model.
他是我们的榜样。
Not other people.
不是其他的教会。
Look, open your mouth and speak loud.
当我们祷告的时候，开口大声的说。
Bible says, out of your mouth. Okay.And Bible says, "Cry unto me, cry it unto me."
圣经上说向我呼求。
And those who cry unto God answered like almost right away.
那些向他呼求的那些。
Those are crying unto God like a baby, like this baby. See, she's crying. Okay. She's crying and coming to the mother, right? And then she gets the attention of the mother very quickly.
比如说那小朋友。他只要一哭一流眼泪，马上就很容易得到父母的这个注意力，是不是
？Same thing with God. He's our Father.
他是我们的父亲。
If they're crying, they're hurt.
如果他的孩子受伤了
God, ，Help me, God, help me, God. God was like, "Oh, what do you need?"
他在这个痛苦当中向神呼求，流泪哀哭
This is one of
神会马上能回应他。
This is one of the secret how you get answered.
这其实是我们祷告蒙应许的一个秘密。
Right when people were in hardship.
当那些人在很多人在痛苦当中
，right? You cried and then you tore your heart to God, right?
他们撕裂心肠，在神面前哭泣。
And God gave the answer. God gave the miracle.
神给他们，神就应许他们，
okay?
神就怜悯他们。
You gotta do that.
我们也要这样去做。
I did the same thing. Okay.
我自己也是这样去做的。
Oh, now giving.
还有就是给予。
This is basic principle of life. If you want to be blessed in your life, you need to be a giver.
这也是一个基督徒的一个基本生活准则。如果你想要生活蒙祝福，你就要成为一个给予的人。
God don't really bless stingy people, you know what I'm saying?
神不会祝福一个小气的人。
Maybe stingy toward themselves and giving on to people.
你可能是对自己小气，但是你对别人要大方。
Okay, her mom is blessed because she's just a natural giver.
我妈妈就是一个很蒙福的人，她就是很喜欢给别人，很喜欢给出去。
She just tried to buy,
非常的大方
buy everything for everybody, basically.
她喜欢很喜欢给别人付钱，她给这样给别人。
So her money doesn't dry, even though people cheat her money, whatever, her money doesn't dry up.
所以虽然她被骗了很多钱，但是呢，她的这个财产上面，经济上面却从来都不会亏损。
Because she didn't know God, of course. She don't know the laws, right? There are other laws too.
当然还有其他的律需要去遵守的，这是我妈所有些是可能不太明白。
Okay, she just know, but she's a natural giver, normally.
她是个很自然的一个很大方的一个人。
Okay. There's another sister, Mary. Okay.
然后我们认识另外一个姐妹 Mary.
She's very giving person.
我们最近在她家一直有聚会，然后 然后我们发现她是一个非常喜欢给予的一个姐妹。
I go there, she'd be all give me best chocolate, best everything, all clothing,
我每次去
她
家
all, give, like, what do you need, like, just give, right?
她都是把他们家里面最好的什么好吃的好用的什么东西都摆了一桌然后就要让我们带回家。
And that's how she evangelizes.
她就是这样去传福音的。
Okay?Remember, this is what you need to evangelize. If you want to evangelize well, give unconditionally, loving.
如果你想要做一个传福音很有果效的人，你要做一个非常愿意去给出去的人。
You really need
不断的给，不断的给。
You get love out of a pure good heart.
然后呢，出一个爱的心，出一个爱他的心，然后不断的去给予他。
Look, if you give some cheap stuff, they know this cheap stuff. You know, they know.
你给他们一些廉价的东西，他们也知道这是廉价的东西。
Oh, those cookies, yeah, I know those are cheap, you know.
给你塞两块饼干，这饼干一看就是很便宜的东西，对不对？
Yeah.
大家都知道，是不是？
But、
他们也
keep on giving, cheaper is good, whatever. You just keep on giving, keep on sharing, keep on giving.
你总是把你家里面好的东西拿出去分享给别人。
They'll be touched. You know what I'm saying?
他们就会很被触动。
Wow, that person's a really good person.
这个真是个好人。
Oh, I love them. I love them.
哇，这个人，我想要去认识他。
Whatever that person wants, I want to give it to them too.
啊，我也想要去跟他们去分享。
You need to give to be blessed.、Now, in the beginning, I only gave to God a lot. You know, I only gave to God. I didn't really do it to people.
我以前在刚开始信主的时候，我只知道要给神。
Give the Bible, church,
我总是给教会，给教会很多。
Whatever they need, I just give. And I never dry up.
所以
I never
那个时候，但是我也没有什么缺乏。
Okay, so that's one of the law that I keep. Now, Proverbs 3:9 it says.
在箴言上第三第九节说：“以你的财物和一切出手的土产和药神，耶和华耶和华。”
Look, ten. I was thinking why ten? Okay.
我们知道说我们要给这个十分之一、
right?
十一奉献。
That was a law. That was a law.
十一奉献呢是在律法当中写的。
No, we're like in grace. We need to give even better.
而我们是在恩典当中，所以在恩典里面，我们应该是给出更多。
Let's say you have something, okay? Let's say this is your possession.
我们举个例子，比如说这个是你所拥有的。
Do you understand? Your hands are like this way, okay? It's 10 fingers.
你手有十个手指。
Okay, 10 means complete.
十呢表示完整。
God said 10 times of the creation. He said, God said.Blah blah blah. God said blah blah blah. He created the whole world in ten.
在神创造里面呢，
speaking 10 times.
他说神说话说了十次。
Okay, God says, I am. I am that I am 10 times in the Revelation.
神在启示录里面呢说
I am 10 times.
就我是耶和华，好像。
What do you mean? I am.
I am 就是他的名字。
He's gonna do whatever he's gonna do.
就是我想要做什么就做什么。
Punish the evil.
审判恶人。
Bless those who follow him.
祝福那一些跟随他的人。
Understand? So he's gonna do whatever.
他说这个说了十次。
God says, I am that I am.
他说了这个十次这句话。
There's ten commandments.
有十诫。
Ten plagues.
有十灾。
Egypt.
有十个手指，十个脚趾。
We have 10 toes, 10 fingers, just like God.
就像神一样。
Okay, you have 十个 whatever, right? And God is what?
神是什么 ？Alpha 和 Omega.
Alpha and Omega.
Alpha 和 Omega.
You're dumb.魔鬼想攻击你的想法 make you not listen. It's very important. Look at your hand. Whatever you possess, first and the last is God's.
当你手上所有的，你手上所抓的东西，你的手的 alpha 就是最开始的，以及你所有的最后的。
It's God's.
都是神的。
Okay.So in the Jewish time, they gave 10% to God, okay?
在犹太人律法里面还是时间里面
This is ridiculous. Ten, they give
10%
to God.
所以在犹太人的这个律法里面，他给十分之一。
Said it's God's.
然后他说这是神的。
And then they give another 10% usually.
然后他通常还会再给另外一个十分之一呢，是什么呢
？For offering.
是给作为那个其他的奉献，
offering.
其他的奉献。
It was to help the poor people.
比如说去帮助其他穷人呐、啊，帮助有病的人呐、啊，或者帮助其他什么事情，
hungry people.
或者饥饿的人呐、啊，他们会再给出一些额外的这个、
okay.
奉献。
They realize this is not theirs.
因为他发现这个手所拿的这个起初和末后啊，这是都是属神的。
And we ought to do the same.
我们也是要这样去做。
Do you know what I'm saying?Of course, people now that we're in grace, there are people give more than 10%, you know.
所以现在我们在这个恩典当中，我知道很多人他都给
people,
给超出十分之一。
And God bless them, like Rockefeller gave like 90%.
比如像那个 Rockefeller 啊
，all the time too.
他喝到后来是百分之九十几的给出去。
He was rich. Yeah. If you keep those law, you'll be wealthy.
所以你遵守这一些神的这个律的时候呢，你的生活就会被蒙福。
Yeah. Even like who's a Bill Gates, a very like giver. I know he's not good, but you know he's a giver. He always like give all kind of foundation. He's also blessed very much. He does his wealth even quadruple whatever through Microsoft. Even he quit.
甚至像比尔盖茨这种虽然我不觉得他这个人很好，但是但是
But he tried to help,
他也给了很多这个
you know, he's using a bunch of money for people. Anyway. First and the last, why is that important?
起初和末后为什么很重要？
Your first fruit is God's, Bible says.
你的初熟的果实应该是给神的。
Do you understand? First fruit, whatever first increase is God's.
所以第一个收入或者是你第一个这个增长或者第一个什么你长出来的。
Your first child,
果实是第一个孩子。
First child is also God's.
也是神的。
Okay, so, I mean, I dedicate all my children.
当然，你不需要给第一个孩子，你可以把所有的孩子。
Yeah, you're the greatest, you know?
对不对？
Every.
因为你在这个恩典当中，你不用只给第一个孩子。
They're not mine. Okay, they're God's.
所有都是神的。
This property is all God's.
所有我所有的都是神。
I don't want to have any.Ownership of anything.
我不想要有这种
ownership. Oh, it's mine. Nothing is mine. It's all given.
主人的意识觉得好，这是我的东西，什么东西都不是我的。
We came naked in this world. We're gonna leave this world naked.
我们赤身肉体来到这个世上，也要赤身肉体离开。
Nothing is ours.
所以没有什么是我们的东西。
How can I say all this is mine?
我说这是我的。
And who's God? Me? No.
那为什么我是神？
It's God.
都是神。
So that's how we view everything. So, Giving is very important. Bible says, "Let's read."
所以，给予是很重要的。在哥林多后书，我们一起看这节经文。
第九章，
他说：“因此，我想不得不求那几位弟兄先到你们那里去，把从前所应许的捐资预备妥当，就显出你们所捐的是出于乐意，不是出于勉强。少种的少收，多种的多收，这话是真的。个人要随本心所酌定，不要作难，不要勉强。”因为捐的乐意的人是神所喜爱的，神能将各样的恩惠多多的加给你们，使你们凡事常常充足，能多行各样善事。
God is able to make all grace abound to you.
啊，神可以将各样的恩惠多多的加给你们。
That you'll always be able to give others too.
使你们可以常常的富足充足，可以更多的行出善事出来。
This is really true.
这个是很真实的。
Don't say, "Oh, if I give, I'm gonna be hungry. I'm gonna be nothing. I'm gonna be poor."
不要就说，哎，我给出去，我就更穷了，我就更少了，不是这样子。
God has a way of pushing it, giving it, multiplying back.
神有这样的一个办法，他可以让你所给出去的再加倍的回到你身上。
Even Jesus said that, right? Give and it shall be given unto you.
耶稣说，给。
Press down, shaken together.
他要给别人。
Press down, overflowing.God will give you.
他说你给别人的时候要叫实际上更多的加给你，而且要连摇大按上尖下流一样的、要给你。
Memorize, okay? You may say, "Oh, it didn't. I don't get anything right now." It may take 1, 2, 3 years when it grows and bear fruit. That's when you receive.
有的时候可能不见得一年两年你能看出差别，但是几年时间那个果实长出来了，你就会看到。
The tree doesn't bear fruit right away. Take some time.
所以树也是这样子的。
Okay.
长一个果实也需要好几年的时间才能够看到这个果效。
Yeah, so do the next one. Here it says,
如经上所记，他施舍钱财，周济贫穷，他的仁义存到永远。那赐种给撒种的，赐粮给人吃的，必多多加给你们种地的种子，又增添你们仁义的果子，叫你们凡事富足，可以多多施舍，就借着我们使感谢归于神。因为拜这供给的事，不但补圣徒的缺乏，而且叫许多人越发感谢神。他们从这供给的事上得了凭据，知道你们承认基督，顺服他的福音，多多的捐钱给他们和众人，便将荣耀归于神。他们也因神极大的恩赐显在你们心里，就切切的想念你们，为你们祈祷，感谢神，因他有说不尽的恩赐。
Just give out of a, you know, good heart.
而带着一颗这个
To your coworkers.To your friends,
带着一个就是
family,
良善的心去给他们，给你的家人，给你的同事，给你周围需要帮助的人。
就是给 skip,
就给他们。
Buy something, buy two and
或者买一些什么东西的时候， okay. 你买两份，给他们带一份。
Okay, so
使他们可以因此而感谢神。
Yeah, and their heart will open.
他们的心也会慢慢的敞开。
Yeah, amen. Yeah.Also, Peter 前书三章八节说 what?
然后 彼得前书第三章第八节说，总而言之你们要同心，彼此体恤，相爱如弟兄，慈慈怜谦卑的心，不要以恶报恶，以辱骂还辱骂，倒要祝福，因你们是为子蒙召，好叫你们承受福气。因为经上说，人若爱生命，愿享美福，需要禁止舌头不出恶言，嘴唇不说诡诈的话，也要离恶行善，寻求和睦，一心追赶。因为主的眼看顾义人，主的耳听他们的祈祷，唯有行恶的人，主向他们变脸。
If you do not love other people, we failed as Christians, literally.
所以如果我们没有办法去爱其他的弟兄姐妹，我们就
we really
就没有做好一个基督徒。
We really need to be loving them. If you really love them, you'll give them nice things. Don't give them garbage. Don't give them useless things. Okay? Oh, I don't need this. It's like garbage. Oh, do you need it? Don't do those things. Okay?
所以我们如果真的是去爱其他的人，我们就会愿意去分享，去给出去。但是不要给垃圾，不要给你自己用觉得不好用的东西，然后就觉得像给垃圾一样给别人。
Oh, you take it, man. You know, don't do it, okay? Do you understand?
像好的东西。
Yeah, get good stuff. It really touches them. It's like, wow, this person really loves me. You know, like their mind open.
当我们这样去爱他们的时候，这样去给出去的时候，
so nice、
他们的心也会被、
nice、
被感动，然后会被打开。
Yeah.Long time ago, somebody, that I don't know, really, and, you know, while we were playing basketball, you know, he hit me and then I kind of like, ah, like hurt, you know?
有一次之前很
多人 bought me like a 7 yuan drink.
我在打篮球的时候呢，有一个人撞到我了，撞到我以后呢，我觉得很痛，然后后来他就给我买了一个7块钱的饮料。
I was like, whoa, you know,
我看这个饮料，我想，哦，这个不是水哦，这是很贵的饮料哦。
Yeah, like, wow, you gave me this? Like, I was like,
shut up.
Like,
你给我买七块钱的饮料，
oh, God, save him, save him,
save him. 哇，我就很开心，我就开始跟他祷告。
I still remember him.
我到现在我还记得他给我买了七块钱的饮料。
Yeah, long time ago, I had a friend, right? I had a friend, and then he got a job, and I didn't, you know, work. I was like poor, you know, compared to him.
在很早很早以前，我有一个朋友，有个朋友他找到一份工作，然后那时候我很穷，我没有工作，他有工作。
And then later I shared the gospel to him.
后来我就跟他分享福音，我就跟他传福音。
And he was a Christian too, but he was not like, you know.
虽然他也是基督徒，但他不是就是说真的很认真的基督徒。
And he gave me $40.
他后来给了我40美金。
Okay, why you give me $40?
那你为什么给我40美金
？I was like just wanna give, you know.
我说我就想要给你。
I was like, wow, I'm just a friend. Why are you?
然后我在想，我就是你一个普通朋友，然后你要给我40美金。
So yeah, I was like, oh Lord God, I sometimes think about it, even now, don't think about it.
甚至到现在，我还想到这个事情，我还会想起这个事情，我就会为他祷告，求神来救他。
Yeah, there is this guy. I want to tell you a story, okay?
我给你们讲一个故事。
Okay. There is this, pastor when he was a child, when he was a young kid,
有一个牧师，在他小的时候，大概10岁左右的时候。
His mom went to church in the morning.
他的妈妈呢，每天早上4点钟就会去教会。
And every time she was passing like by a beggar.
然后那个妈妈每一次经过教会的时候，都会路过经过一个乞丐。
Just like everybody else.
但是呢
，Oh, you know, just hurry up and walk away, you know.
他每次看到那个乞丐的时候呢，他就跟其他人的反应一样。
Give a dollar and walk away.
或者他给个1美金或者是2美金，他就赶紧就走开了。
And then one day she went to pray and then come out, got kind of convicted, I guess.
然后有一次他从祷告会里面走出来，他又看到那个乞丐，然后神就感动他。
So she brought this old blind man, blind. Yeah, he was blind and dirty.
然后呢，他就去把这个。瞎眼的这样的一个乞丐呢，把他带过来，带到哪里去
？Yeah, brought home.
带到自己家里去。
And then she said, "We're gonna live with him today."
然后他就对他们家里人说，从现在开始，我们要和他一起住了。
Wash him.
给他清洗。
So he's like, "I don't want to do that," you know.
然后那个
like pee pee poop all over the place.
那个十岁的那个小孩
，all over.
他就觉得很不愿意，他说我不要跟他一起洗
，his toe is dirty.
不要跟他洗澡，因为他很臭很臭，身上各种各样的味道都有。
So he just stick.
他就拿了一个棍子
，to take off his clothes，
用棍子把他的衣服这样脱掉。
And he said the clothes are like thick leather because of so dirt, oil, and whatever is.
他说那个衣服都已经脏的，就是已经都很厚很厚，那就是快碎掉了，就是。
You know， And he did that, and he complaining and just washing.
然后一边抱怨，一边就给他洗。
Oh, my mom, you know, brought this old guy here, you know.
然后就一边在抱怨，然后一边就在给他洗澡。
And that guy's like, oh, it feels good when you're getting washed.
然后那个当然那个乞丐他就觉得很开心，因为他水洗过一下很舒服。
And then you know, because these Christians were like Holy Spirit filled, like us, you know.
啊，那他们妈妈，他们这些基督徒啊，都是圣灵充满的基督徒。
He started prophesying. God just gave the prophecy
to the
old man.
然后那个乞丐呢，在他们中间，突然神就给他这样的一个发预言的灵，他就开始发预言。
Yeah, and then he gave very happy and things like that, right?
啊，他就开始跟他们发预言。
And later on, years later, years.
后来过了很多很多年以后。
He went to some meeting and some prophet was prophesying over him.
Who is going to what meeting?
This pastor when he became a pastor.
然后这个小男孩长大了，他做了一个牧师。然后他长大以后，他就参加了一个聚会。
And then God was telling him.
然后就有一个人给他发预言说。
When you did that.
他说当你小的时候做这样一件事情。
It was me.
他说那个人其实就是我。
You did it to me.
当时神跟他说，你当时给他洗澡的那个人就是我。
And because you blessed me.
因为你祝福了我。
When I didn't have a home, you gave me a home.
当我没有家的时候，你给了我一个家。
I'll bless you that you'll never lack anything in your life.
我现在向你应许，在你的一生当中，你不会有任何的缺乏。
So God always blessed him, always.
所以神一直都祝福他，
Everything.
一直都祝福他。
It doesn't stop.
一直到现在都没有停下。
Do you understand?
明白吗？
So do that.To the people,
所以带着这样的一个心去服侍周围的人
，especially the 孤儿 the 寡妇，
尤其是孤儿寡妇
，just go help them raise them if you want to raise them, go help them pray for them.
可以去帮他们带孩子，可以照顾他们，甚至那些孤儿，你还可以带回家，你自己养。
There are like 外国人 doing that, you know.
很多的外国人来到中国来。
Taiwan people doing that.
台湾的人，然后那些国外的人来到中国来领养孤儿。
They're doing that to the people, and they're going to be blessed when they go to heaven.
当他们这样去做，他们回到天家的时候，要得到很多的祝福。
Do you know what I'm saying? They're gonna be blessed. Yeah. So do that because you're doing it to Jesus.
当我们这样去做的时候，我们是坐在了主的身上。
Amen. So we don't be selfish.
我们不要。
But loving.
不要自私，要有个爱的心。
Yeah. So we'll end with that today.
我们在这个地方结束我们今天的讲道。
These are the basic principles.
这是一些在基督教信仰当中一些很基础的。一些蒙福的原则
that we should live by
是我们需要去遵守的
Amen So let's do these diligently and we shall like anything hopefully Amen
我们认真的去做
Yeah
神就会供应我们一切